The guy steadily improved through January, reaching an 8-4 record. In the latter weeks of January, they faced two top teams, one on a Friday night at home, Valley of California, and a Saturday night game on the road at the Adventure State Champion, Notre Dame. Both games will be played without Mike Buckeye, the team's lead scorer. Our Indians fought valiantly, but lost both games to fall to 8-6. Over the next 13 games, the Indians did not lose once. During that 13-game winning streak, St. Vincent played the championship of two tournaments, the N-AAA conference tournament and the school first-ever boys' district tournament. Unfortunately, the team's great run was stopped the sectional round of the state tournament by South Dean County out of Ashland. The team finished with a record of 21-7, the best boys' record in school history at the time. Please help me to recognize some of the members of that 30-year team. First, we'd like to mention those who could not attend tonight's reunion. Ms. Rose Unreiner Oaks. Rose was a team manager and staff member. Three of the recruiters on that team, Chris Johnson, Steve Klump, and Jason Meyer.
Thank you.
the pages I have in front. Breaking the school record for wins at the time was great. Winning the NCAA tournament was definitely a high point. Winning the first boys' district tournament in school history was huge. He goes on to say, I have so many vivid memories of James Bezos causing absolute mayhem on defense, Brian Lott making some awesome yield-breaking passes inside, Brad Suter out-rebounding somebody a foot taller than him, or Mike Buckeye getting the foul, but still making a shot and getting a free throw from both schools to rebound. Another thing that I think is incredibly special about our team is whoever was sitting on the bench was always supporting whoever was on the court at the time. The sounds of the crowd in the gym still echo in my head, too. But maybe my best memory is the last time we played Valley in the district tournament finals. We had never lost to Valley going all the way back to 7th grade. At halftime, we were losing 20-18. We were slow, sloppy, and getting outplayed at Bowman's in the quarter. I don't remember exactly what Coach Cooper said in the locker room, but I do remember his intensity. Nobody was really looking at each other when we got up to leave the locker room. During the shoot around before the third quarter, there wasn't much talking. Usually, this was the time to psych each other out. I remember seeing the intensity of everybody's face, and I knew we were going to make something happen. And did we ever? 6.5 minutes into the third quarter, Valley finally scored their first basket. But by then, we were up 34-22. That would be their only points of the quarter. Our full court press was killing them as they struggled to just let the ball pass half court. The game ended with 53-29 win. Our team played some good defensive game, only down to just 9 points in the second half to be us. It was a total team win. Coach Cooper used to repeat, team stands forward, together, everyone accomplishes more. I carry those words home to this day. It relates to everything in life, marriage, family, work, etc. And together, I think, the 86-87 boys basketball team accomplished some pretty good things. Maybe the best memory is just to know how lucky I am enough. I was lucky enough to be a part of that team. Coach Keith Winkler. Keith was an assistant coach on the team. He currently lives in Perryville. He and his wife Mary have been married for 4 years. They have 2 daughters, Kayla, who is a graduate of St. Vincent and is currently attending Fox Rock University, and Jenna, who is a current junior at St. Vincent. Keith currently is a teacher at Perry County District 32. In 2004, he led our St. Vincent football team to the state championship. His best memory that season is winning the NCAA Conference Tournament. He adds, coming into the tournament as one of the players and defeating the better one-seed Frederick Town in the semifinals. We had the Frederick Town radio man sitting behind our bench, and when we ran the inbound break under our basket, we called Brad Suter to look like he was shooting an air ball, but really it was past Brian Lott, right on the screen on the other side of the basket with an easy 5-foot shot. I remember the radio guy yelling, it's an air ball. Oh wait, it's a pass. And the bench just started laughing. The basket helped us to stop the Frederick Town run, and we never looked back. Coach Tim Lee. Once again, the 1986-87 men's basketball team. Thank you. Perryville, please rise and stand up for our prayer. Dear God, let each of us play well above fair. Let this competition make each of us stronger but never hostile. Let each of us be cheered when we bend to help by holding up. If we know victory, allow us to be happy. If we know defeat, keep us on poor sportsmanship and envy. Remind us that sports are just games. Help us to learn something that matters once the game is over. And if through athletics we set an example, please let it be a good one. Amen. And now the national anthem. Forward starting lineup from Grandview, number 30, the sophomore, Colton McIntyre. 14, sophomore Jared Wheat. Number 11, senior Sam Husky. Number 3, sophomore Eli Moore. And number 1, junior Anthony Foley. Number 42, senior Luke Whitman. 32, senior Tyler Moon. Number 20, junior Matt Wellington. Number 12, junior Brennan Lucas. Number 10, junior Evan Whitford.
Hey, who's ready for some boys basketball tonight? Wibbenmeyer and number 14, Luke Wibbenmeyer, number 3 to for Grandview Eagles, Bulldogs, Pip Hill. Ball starts with Grandview, number 1 is going to bring it up past the timeline. Number 11 gets in there. 3-point shot, shot up, no good. Wibbenmeyer returns it. Number 10, Mooney, I believe. Oh, quickly. Ball was trying to come right at me. Go, 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 32 for the Indians. Now number 12, Luke Fuller. Number 32 tried to put the ball in. That was Munoz. Travel for the Indians. Jimmy calls it. There's Jimmy right there. Half court shot to number 14 are over, more than a half court shot. Number one for the Grandview Eagles. Puts up, no good. Number 14 with the ball. Throws it up, the ball, it's in the net, but it's a travel. And it will go back to the Indians as Wibbenmeyer will throw it to Lucifer. It's Trevor. Number 10 with the Stephen Curry shooting, but Evan Cookin. See if we have. It's Blue Knight as Lucifer. By the way, senior night on Tuesday night for the senior boys. Really, I guess you could just announce everybody. Grandview at 3-17, 3-5. Of course, tonight, 55 miles north or something like that, at the Owl Country, is Perryville at Windsor. Might go beef up that a little later on. Perryville would like to win tonight against Windsor and then win Tuesday night to win their conference and girls basketball. Girls couldn't win conference last night, girls basketball. Herculean block. So 14 for the Feathers of Grandview Eagles. Jimmy's like, hey guys, be careful. Number 32, Tyler Munier for three. Come on, looks like he might get some. Wow, I'm surprised they didn't call him for a time on violation. Eagles, did they get that? Trevor Lucifer decides to fall down here right in front of us. Right in front on the account. Jimmy's like, okay, now listen. You got two shots to see if you can shoot that ball into the living room. Don't be scared to hit the camera. He's got the shooter. See if we can get it like right there in the picture. Well, the ball's gonna come right at you. Right in front of you in the kitchen, diner, and wherever you're watching the world. Jump ball. see if you can get a good one. Lucifer with it. So you get triple back, triple. You're like, where is Sterling? There he is. I found him. I'll be scared he's here. Take over the Beefle Brace just yet. They do up for a 3-point shot. All decide to find a few Indian fans. The bridge still close now. It's Friday night. Nice good basket. Where are you guys at? Do you not like coming here no more? You'll be here for this too. Well, you know where to how the boys' district sets up on Tuesday. Evan Coulson. Hey, Daryl, don't be talking to him about going to Beef or Braves again now. Come on. This game kind of seems like it's got dunk feeling in it. Third quarter, East Prairie Eagles, 35. Killhawks, 31. Let's give you guys a little bit of scores. Local interest, like I mentioned, try to keep you up on the game at St. Pius. You get two tries to get the ball. You don't get three, guys. You know that. Lucifer with two. Grandview for two. Grandview down by five. Almost a three by number 20, I believe that was. 10. Not for sure. Good pressure there. They said the full court pressure against Val. They didn't let Val Catholic even get a ball. Only 2 points in one quarter. St. Vincent Indians girls did a lot better than that. They held Perryville with no points in the third quarter of the girls' varsity game of the Mayor's Cup. Fan run it, so I had to walk across the court. I don't know if we could are allowed to show that or not. Professionally, you're not allowed to. If we're not allowed to, I'm sorry for it. At least you know what they say when they, you know, fan has ran it onto the court, onto the ball field, and they're not allowed to show it. Now. Now you know why, because the announcers are hungry in the booth. Just a figure, you know, speaking of that, one of the men that couldn't be here tonight for the annual reunion, remember on the A7 team, he is actually one of the men in the front office with the Pittsburgh P-I-R-A-T-E-F. That's why I get the air, because he's got to be down there wherever the spring training is. So. Now, if this game would have been at Perryville, he might have been there, because Perryville's the home of the Pirates. See if any other young older fans decide to run out and say to Daryl, you're doing a great job working tonight, you know, with Jimmy and our other buddy, maybe the fans will try to go out there and get every book in the signs of the night. That's why they were on it. They heard him. He's like, you know, can shoot like Stephen Curry with the Golden State Warriors. These are the Golden State Warrior Indians. Golden State is blue and yellow, so. Daryl pointed his hand like it's to Parrot, St. Vincent, and then Grandview. Riley was trying to backhand it like LeBron James. Riley Green, the outstanding baseball player, football player, runner back. Let's do that 5'11" senior. Our runner's going to be faced on number 21 for the Hawks. sorry, with the Philadelphia Eagles. Correction, with the Grandview Eagles. $5 to get in the district. Riley pulls up for three, bounces off the rim. Back to the Indians, number 32. Munier over to Riley. Under Riley. The 32. End of one quarter. Jim Kim, you know, is going to have a cheer for you. So we're going to let you enjoy that. By the way, here on High School Basketball Friday action. But don't forget, you can see all your sports that we cover on PVTV 95 Digital Media. That's the way to find it on YouTube. PVTV 985 on Facebook. Myself and Cole will be here September 15th, where all the 3,000 folks will be. Maybe not Riley Ryan, but we know they'll all try to make it out here. Grandview only scored 6 points in 8 minutes of action. What? They're only going to put Trevor at the line, then just assign him that position, standing there to shoot free throws. There's a nice new net that the senior girls took off yesterday. Nothing but net there. Looking to sweep on the Eagles. Sweep the Eagles out of their nest. Remember, we didn't have Grandview in football. They chickened out. Or they couldn't get out of their nest in time. So we had a team from Northern Illinois, Rockets. Of Rock Ridge, whatever you want to say up there in the Des Moines, Iowa. Excuse me, Davenport, Iowa, Moline, Illinois. Where John Deere Factory is originally from. To have his own little so Bruce got technical. Foul. Maybe get a foul if you yell really loud. That's Case Bruce. You better quiet down out here. There's good old Keith Winsler, coach, hanging out with the guys that he taught and the ladies. He threw candy to everybody during the game. Nothing but that for number one. 32, Munier, quarterback. All he knows how to do is throw the ball. Clifton takes it to the house. Looks like somebody dripped some water here on the floor. We do know somebody did drop their cup of water last night. Able to go clean it up without running away and taking care of it. Good sportsmanship right there. Oh, I get it. The girls, everybody's young. Water, water, water on the floor. Must be a little bit of dampness outside. See no St. Bernard dog in there. It's not looking for its Peyton. Yeah. I make ball. Back to Evan Clifton with the point. Darren Ernst. Just about halftime. Just wanted to let y'all know the floor is not wet. I'm not playing on the watery surface floor. We're not in a rain delay. Never had one in basketball. Had a little bit of a light delay against Turkey Lane when the football came this previous season. Remember that? Mr. Chapman Bryan's like, what did you do? The lights are off? I'm like, well, hey, you're in maintenance at TT. You can fix it.
Thank you.
Last 46 seconds remaining in the six seconds to go till halftime. Halftime. Be back. Sorry that we missed the first 3 seconds. One of the players shot a basketball right at the tripod here. Not shot it, but bounced up, and it was not St. Vincent. It was our Grandview, whoever they are. Perryville got 4 points. St. Vincent. Hey, speaking of Perryville, Perryville takes the win over the Windsor Owls this evening on account of 64-52, according to senior player number one, Aaron Mueller. Got that information just during the half. So Perryville will be playing for a conference title next Tuesday. We will not have it because we will be over here for senior night on Heart Night, Red Heart Night, Valentine's Night also. When the player hit the tripod, the camera went like this, and then it shut off. So I'm not for sure if there's a shark or anything. We're going to hopefully be able to figure whatever it's going on with it. St. Vincent leads 42-23. Winter boys lose both varsity games to the city of Perryville, community of Perryville. Speaking of community, did you know there's a high school known as Community High School? It's north of Mexico City, north of Columbia, but it's still a high school, not in class three. So. been a long game according to Mass. But hey, it's Friday evening. What are you expecting it being a long night? Hey, Mass, you can play a locker. Soccer, maybe. Lock the ball with the combine. Coach, I'm 160, Coach Terry. Coach Terry Wood, there we go. He's like, well, they're down here and he's seen something on the floor. By the way, the young fan who ran across the court during the play. It was a stoppage of play. So. Still seeing, so we're not going to have a stoppage of play, hopefully. Just about 9 o'clock here in the brief score, see if we got score that we're looking for. No such thing as that. We'll be checking on Seymour ball sooner or later then. Perryville's already posted a win up there at Windsor, where you can pretty much guarantee yourself a win unless you're volleyball or baseball. Other than that, you can pretty much guarantee a win, just like the St. Vincent and Perryville boys basketball game. That's 9 straight years that Perryville boys have beat Windsor. Just to give you a little bit of an idea how long has it been since Vincent's been able to beat Perryville's boys in basketball. There you go. Evan Clinton's like, hey, you're talking about Perryville, but hey, we're hoping to score more than Perryville did tonight. We already scored more than Perryville did Tuesday night. I mean, last Monday night, you know, from 65 to 13. Vincent scored that even before the halftime. So, a week from tomorrow, this high school boys basketball all day long. We will not have that district for you. Because of money. The tripod was getting too close to the edge. Wonder if they'll put a tent up if it gets to midnight here. Been a long game. Whoa. Everybody's like, we like seeing the blue and yellow there on the, you know, glass and doors, touch of doors. But do you think you can actually show us the game? Well, I'm sorry, folks. Foxy Jensen is still down there setting up a tent for the Wallace. Be alert. Here. Yeah, the ceiling looks good. Okay. Did that last night in the girls' games. Make sure that, you know, nobody threw a basketball and stuck up there like, you know, did on the run Tuesday in Perry the country.
Yeah.
just about lost my shoe. She tried to leave.
Said, we've been here long enough. We've been here since 5 o'clock, you know. Pretty too far. Scammer has been set for about 4 hours. Got set up about 5:15. Justin's like, you know what, you might be in a shot in the background, so just shot Justin with the paper. One of the professional sports players and photographers here in Perryville. Played basketball with his twin brother.
Is a cheerleader know how to block the ball, so if you end up deciding you want to throw a basketball. Then wait for legal substitutions.
Daryl! Now I know you want to get home and eat supper, but you know you're
here to see Cody and myself and you know play a good game. By the way, there's Cody. I even look at his way, it's okay. He's watching his relative work. Number 12. Looking for. Shot clock has already expired. It's already been on. See my body, guys. Okay, 12 Central Park is 25 at halftime.
Oh, several of our basketball players over here. See Megan, Jen, and Jackie. Snurbush on the bottom and kicking one to the right into St. Vincent group. It's a 100-yard dash. Cares the second one back. Well, there's Jay, by the way, Blues hockey player. Just about 1 point away from 50. Turning now. Both Massons. I know Shelby Schumer and Masson leader for the team. Robinson Construction over there. Dave Linear. So we're in good hands. The ring gets broken. Dave's here to fix it. Hey, Kylie caught that ball. He's a wide receiver basketball player. He's like, you know, I've been out of school 5 years just about. Perryville, I can still catch the ball now. No, I actually caught it in the long reach in the JV hotel. Mr. Heron said, hey, to one of the players, hey, if you throw it again over here, we're going to keep it. So he never did throw it again. It was Ryan Daster. Or Nathan Cuss. Six oh one to play. Indians up by 19. Is St. Vincent gonna be a three-share conference title for law schools? St. Vincent is looking to win and breaking up my losing streak by 2 games. Guys who you know, came back pretty much to enjoy their Indian basketball team that they loved so much, to both Winkler boys. I'd say they're enjoying it as much as everybody else is here tonight. Well, stuck around. A lot of people have left. Or just hanging out down there with Jay. So if we end up playing them, then I'm sure Jay's going to bring us some breakfast from my group. But guess what? If we had to play them in there, I would not be. Might be a technical here. There's like coaches was out right in there. Roots. Call that timeout. You know where the camera's going? Because we're pretty soon the game will be over. We're predicting 51-33. How late will it be? That's Ryan time for Wheel of Fortune. How late? 51-33. How late will it be? The category is Ryan time. Keep in mind, there's numbers in the puzzle. Wheel of Fortune, yes. Can I have a... Okay, Wheel of Fortune, it's proper name. Can I have an S? Yeah, there's a few S's, maybe. Yeah, there's two S's. I would like to buy an I. Yeah, there's a few of those in here also. I want to solve the puzzle. St. Vincent Indians. That's the puzzle, I believe, tonight. Or is there a D in there? Or a G? What's on positive? Grandview Eagles. Well, that's correct. There's Clifton there, trying to hide from me, which he did. There he is. Lucifer. Oh. 53-33, up by 20. St. Vincent's gonna win this ball game. You got it. You gotta also guess Grandview's gonna have a long night. Hey, did you want Jenna to shoot three? I'm sorry, they're not in their gear tonight. I don't see Abby Buckett. I know she's somewhere around here. Or maybe you want Clifton to shoot three from all the way over here at the stand section. Lucifer. Wibbemeyer with the point. Grandview is 3-17, and they're looking like they're decks better than Perryville. Folks, we can only recover 102 more minutes of basketball, so just keep that in mind if you want, you know, add an extra two quarters. As it's getting ready to have a second half. The reason why I'm saying that, yesterday at work they thought I was getting a second lunch. I guess I worked so good I'd get these other second lunch maybe. Is that why we got permission to come here with all of our Walmart workers on hand here? Just kidding. A C2, a technically C3 because I'm one of them. Bruce talking it over. You Grandview fans. Daryl. Hey, let's see if we can do a replay. Daryl. Daryl, you pick that up and you throw it away. Daryl's going to, Daryl's fouled. on the towel shot. St. Vincent and I get to shoot two free throws for that. The referees have one foul on them. Darryl can't make the shot. Victory's in sight. I'm guessing I'll be hearing that any second. Oh, Florida State just arrived. High school folks. Coming down to it. Is your final. Indians take the win. Grandview goes to 3-18. We'll be back Monday or Tuesday evening for senior night for the boys. Good night from Indian territory. See you Tuesday. That's a wrap. Back to Mr. Cook in the studio.